You record at a home studio. Sometimes me wonder, man, how come my recordings don't sound good? Or how come business isn't as good as it could be? My name is L. Marquis, musician, rapper, record producer, unashamed craftsman lover, and today we're going to talk about the most common home studio mistakes.
L. Marquis Productions.
First mistake is recording too loud. Sometimes when I get tracks to mix that were recorded in other people's studios, the tracks were just recorded too loud. This is usually a result of turning the gain up too high on your preamp and then recording your vocals too loud to the point where you're recording in the red and when they're clipping and distorting. You usually don't want that in your recordings. You usually want to be in the green, tapping the yellow a little bit, but never going over that into the red. And when you're recording the red, it's extremely hard to get the clipping noise out, pretty much impossible. But if that's not what you're going for and you desire a clean and professional sound, just turn the gain down on your preamp a little bit. Sometimes this is also due to producers mixing their beats super loud. A common situation is that you're recording over a beat that's mixed super loud and then the artists can't hear themselves, so then you turn up the gain on your interface or your preamp, and now they can hear themselves but their vocals are coming in just mad distorted. So in this situation, rather than boosting the volume of your mic, turn down the beat a little bit, maybe adjust the headphone volume, and then record. Also, producers, you need to start leaving more headroom in your beats for artists to record over. Arguably, the most important instrument in a song is the vocals, so you need to leave space for that most valuable instrument. Another common mistake is not using any acoustic treatment. It doesn't matter how expensive your interface is or how nice your mic is, if a bunch of room noise gets into your recordings, they're not going to sound professional. Even a little bit of treatment can go a long way. Even the little bit of treatment that I have in my studio transformed my recordings from sounding like they were done in a cave to them sounding a lot more dry and in your face. Additionally, your mixes will likely be improved because you'll be hearing the sound more accurately. If you're mixing a room with bare walls and the sound is just bouncing back and forth between all the walls, that's going to color the sound and you're not going to be able to hear it accurately. And then you may be making mixed decisions that are hurting the sound more than they're helping it. It may not be easy to find out what type of acoustic treatment that you need for your room, but it's definitely worth the time to study and invest in. Another really common mistake is only relying on word of mouth to build your clientele. I definitely admit that most of the clients that I record in the studio found out to me by word of mouth rather than me reaching out to them. And this happened because I happened to be in a situation where some of the artists who I initially worked with started to get a little bit of local buzz, and then they were kind enough to inform other artists about my services. While I have gotten good business on word of mouth alone, it could be improved if I went out and reached out to other artists rather than always waiting for them to come to me. If you only wait on people to come to you, there may be times when business is a bit slow. Also, if you're in a situation where not too many people have worked with you and you have multiple days of the week where you're completely open, you need to be reaching out to other people to fill out those time slots. And there are tons of ways that you can reach out to new artists. Go to local open mic nights, shows, reach out to them on social media, find local artists on YouTube, SoundCloud, and Reverb Nation, and tell them how you can improve their sound. It will take some extra time, but if you're not booked up every single day of the week, then obviously you do have the time. A really, really, really big mistake is showing up late to a session. This is a problem for both the engineer and the artist. It's disrespectful if either of them show up later than the time that they agreed on. If an artist is late, they miss out on the time that they paid for, and then they may have to rush to finish their songs, especially if the engineer is strict about starting and ending sessions on time, which they should be. And if the engineer is late, then the artist is not going to be happy with them. They'll be having to wait on the engineer, and then they may not want to come back to record again. Everyone has a busy schedule and responsibilities to handle outside of the studio. Respect everyone's time by starting and ending the session at the time that you agreed on. And another really, really, really big mistake is not being prepared for the session. Sometimes artists will book a session and their songs won't be done. They may not even know what they want to work on. They just book the session and start winging it. Doing this will cause your sessions to not be as productive as they can be. With the exception of sessions that you're creating songs completely on the spot, you should come there with your songs fully written and ready to record. That way you'll be able to go through songs quicker and more efficiently. If you want to record some rough drafts and then come back at a later date to fix them, that's totally your business, but that will cost you more time and money. These are some very common mistakes that are made by those who either record at a studio or run one. Correcting these mistakes will result in higher quality recordings, better mixes, and better business. Thank you for watching this video. If you like what you've seen today, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel and turn on notifications so you know whenever I upload new videos. Also, be sure to visit my website, lmarquisproductions.com, where you'll be able to check out my music, my beats, my sample kits, as well as my services. Now go down in the comment section below and let me know, what are some other mistakes that are often made in home studios? My name is L. Marquis, L. Marquis Productions. God bless.